Hello, Standard 8. Here we are with the first chapter of Geography, and the name of the chapter is Resources. Resources, I'm very sure that you have heard this word earlier also, but we will redefine this term in this chapter. See, what is a resource? Anything which is present in your environment, which is very useful, plus which satisfy your need is a kind of resource. Okay, so I have told you three parts. First, which one is present in your environment, second, which is very useful, and third, which satisfied your need is a kind of resource. For example, book. I am seeking for knowledge. I opened the book. I gained my knowledge. It satisfied my need. So, book is a resource. Fan. I am under heat. I felt very hot. I switched on the fan. And now I am feeling very cool. I am feeling very happy. So, it satisfied my need. So, fan is a resource. Fan, book, food, which all things give you certain things to satisfy your need is a kind of resource. Fine. See, all the resources have two things. The first one is utility and the second one is value. All the resources are useful for us, so all of them have certain kind of utility plus they have certain kind of value. Now, what kind of value they do have? See, values are of two types. First one is economical value and the second one is non-economical value. I am taking example of two things. The first one is metal and the second one is a beautiful landscape. See, metal, they do have their economic value. It helped me in monetization. But the second thing is a beautiful landscape. Whenever I am feeling sad, I am sitting inside the landscape. I am sitting in front of the landscape and it is satisfying my needs. So both of them are satisfying my needs, but metal in an economical value, but landscape in a non-economical value. So both of them are resource for me. So resource may or may not have economical or non-economical value. Fine? See, we the humans, we are also a kind of resource and we are known as human resource. Our ideas, our knowledge, our intellectuality, all these things help to develop or new discoveries to the world. For example, the first invention of fire led to the invention of many of the other things which are related to cooking or any other thing, like gas, like LPG, like CNG, or many other things have been developed after the invention of fire. And fire was invented by human, so humans are also a kind of resource. Second one is wheel. Many of the other wheels have been developed after the discovery of the wheel. So the wheels are also developed by human. So wheels is also the invention of human. So humans are also resource. So there are many resources. You must have listened to that one quote, that is you must have heard that quote, that is, desire is the mother of discovery. Yes. So all to have, which we all are having in our mind, we can turn into discovery with the help of the human resource. So for this sequence, I am leaving you with the three questions. Question number one, define the resource and give example. Question number two, what do you mean by human resources? And question number three, what is the difference between the value of a landscape and a metal? That's all in the sequence. In the next sequence, we will continue with the chapter. Thank you so much.